सेंट जोसेफ्स इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल विजयपुर, सेवेंथ स्टैंडर्ड, यूनिट 3, ए लेटर फ्रॉम ए मदर बाय मैरी एन केन, प्रेजेंटेड बाय महानंदा। इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द ऑथर। मैरी एना केन lives near the bend in one of the three rivers of Fort Wayne, Indiana, where she teaches prose writing, rhetoric, and women's studies at Indiana University, Purdue University at Fort Wayne. Her works have published in numerous journals. Books written by her are Revisioning Writer's Talk and On From Moonshine, and her journals are The Little Megan Eyes in 2014, Under The Sun in 2014, Many Mountains Moving in 2014, and Sun Megan Eyes, etc. Children, letters have been playing a crucial part in history for thousands of years. The first ever handwritten letter was thought to have been sent by the Persian queen Atossa in around 500 BC, according to the ancient historian Hellenicus. Their popularity as a way of sending messages grew as more people became literate. Although electronic forms of communication have now largely taken over from the handwritten letters, it still holds a place close to our hearts. Children, we had already discussed about the two proses and two poems of our English textbook. I hope that you all have wrote all the notes and grammar which have provided to you, and also hope that you are preparing them well with the daily studies. Students, this is the condition which has not been imagined by any one of us, but even also we should perform our bonded duties for us as like teaching for you studying. If we people are doing our duties correctly, then it doesn't affect on our outcome. I mean the result. So children, without wasting our time, put your daily efforts on your studies. Okay, now we should go for introduction of the lesson. The lesson, A Letter from a Mother, tells us about a mother who writes a letter to her daughter Poonam, who was then studying in a residential school. Residential school means, what do you mean by residential school? Residential school means where students should stay there only. They will become apart from their families, apart from their houses, and they should have to stay in those schools only for 2 years, for 3 years, for 4 years, like that. ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ರೆಸಿಡೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ವಸತಿ ಶಾಲೆಗಳು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ನೋನ್ What forced the parents to admit to her to a residential school? The mother thinks that it is strange to write a letter because her daughter was always close to her. They understood each other with a few words spoken to each other. But now her daughter is away from home and she is growing up quickly. Before long, her daughter will become independent and will be ready to fly away like a bird. See children, one more another day in future. In everyone's life, this situation will come where for one or another reason, we should have to leave our local place, I mean our family, whether it will be for the purpose of education or it will be a purpose for a job. Anyhow, so in future, one such a situation will come that we should have to leave our families, leave our native places. So at that time, the separation from the family members, especially from the mother, which will bring much more affection, which relation will bring in between much more affection. About the affection, about the love, about that attachment, the lesson is telling. Now, look at the first paragraph. Children, it is better if you are taking your textbook in front of you. It is strange to write because I am so used to you being close by. We say a lot without words, you know. But now you are away and I cannot help but think of how you are growing up so quickly. So, this is only the first of more and more times apart until, like a bird, you will be ready to fly away. It will be my greatest joy to see you strong and confident, even as it brings me sorrow to be apart. See children, now only I told you that in future one such a situation will come, whether it will be for the job purpose or whether it will be an education purpose. One or another cause, we should have to leave our locality, we should have to leave our family, and we should have go very far from our family members. So at that time the mother is telling that it will be my greatest joy to see you strong and confident. See children, in the family what will happen? Many children, they are not doing their works their own. They are dependent on their family members, especially on mother. She should have fill up their water bottle. She should have give them a tiffin box, filled tiffin box. She should have washed their socks. And she should only have cleaned their shoes. So everything. Even also many children are not covering their textbooks and notebooks. Even also fathers are helping to their children. So like that, in this lesson, the mother is she is having a very greatest joy that her daughter became strong and confident. Even as it brings me sorrow to be apart. Even also in her heart, the sorrow is there. Why sorrow is there? Sorrow is there because her daughter is becoming apart from her heart, apart from her family. So that's why in one side The mother is feeling sorrow because her daughter is apart from her. But in another side, she felt so great that today my daughter is going away from me, from my family, huh? And she should build such a strong character, confident. So in one way she is very happy, and in another way she is very sorrow. It is not only thing of a mother only, because the lesson is about the mother. So that's why we are discussing about only mother. But even also to all the family members, whether father is there, grandparents are there, younger, elder, sister, brothers are there, to everyone, it is a happy thing and as well as a sorrow one. See, just like in the letter of a mother, letter from a mother, see, the mother is also comparing her daughter to a bird, as like a bird. As you are looking in the picture, that when the small birds are there, so at that time the mother bird is giving them a food, and after that one or another day they will become a grown up. When they will become grown up, they will fly and move away from their nest. So like that in the human beings also same thing will happen. From the child to grown up, you can also observe in the picture. Okay, like that, this is the mother's relation with her children. Next para, being apart may be a good thing. In this way, it makes me put into words those things I feel and think but don't say. For instance, it pleases me that you are so strong-minded and persistent. You are not easily discouraged, even when you do not succeed at first. Remember the time when you could not do your multiplication tables. The teacher was going faster than you could manage, and you felt bad that you were unable to keep up. See, here the mother is giving one such an example of her daughter when she was living with her family in her childhood. So one example she is giving, when her maths teacher was teaching in a class about multiplications, at that time the daughter, the mother's daughter, she felt very bad. Why? Because teacher was going very fastly, and the daughter, she was not able to follow the teacher at that time. Multiplications tables, she was not able to follow her teacher. So at that time, that daughter, she felt very bad, and she was unable to keep up. So very fastly, I think she used to write on the board, and this child was not able to follow her teacher. But you made your own study cards and asked me and daddy to help you. And when you succeeded, finally, in learning those tables, you were independent enough to think through your problems, but responsible enough to ask for help to learn. See, children, what will happen? After that, when in this situation about which the mother is talking in the letter, which letter she is writing to her daughter, that daughter who is living in the residential school. So in that letter, the mother is discussing about her one such a small problem which has happened in her childhood, in her daughter's childhood, about the problem of multiplication tables. When she couldn't follow her math teacher's multiplication tables, so at that time that child, she felt very bad. And after coming home, she asked the help of her parents, her mother's help she asked, her father's help she asked, and after asking their help, she was able to finally learn about the multiplications table. And finally she learned those tables by making such a study cards. Okay, and to make a study cards, her parents helped her. So like that, children, in our home also, our parents are also helping us. But when they will help? They will help when we people are asking for their help. See, children, after going to home, if you people are not discussing about your problems with your parents, how can they help? Without your asking, they can't help. So it is very, very important to each and every child, each and every student, to discuss about their problems about a particular subject. Okay, you people should not hesitate to ask such a problem in the home to parents, in the school to your teacher. So the teacher which are very familiar to you, or those subject teachers, so you people should not hesitate to ask your problems, ask your confusions. Otherwise they will set in the mind same. So it is very important to you to clear those all confusions, those all problems. You should better ask to related concerned teacher, or after going home you can also take the help of your parents or family members. Now next para, I know you are in new surroundings with the new people at your hostel, and the way things you done at home are not same. You have to be careful to look after yourself, since no one is going to ask you how you are or care about your comforts. See, children, you can also see one such a, in the left side, one such a hostel inner scene is there, where the children are sitting on their beds. And in the right side, you can also see the classroom picture, where on the board such a teacher is drawing something. Okay, like that, when her daughter is living in the hostel, in the residential school, so she should have to live with a new people in a new hostel, and the ways things are done at home are not the same in the hostel. See, children, whatever things we are doing in our homes, those things we can't do in the hostel. And you have to be careful to look after your yourself, since no one is going to ask you. See, in the home, in our house, in our family, what will happen? Such things we are not doing ourselves. As like I had already given the example of about your shoes, about your socks, about your uniforms, about your clothes, about your bed. So after that, everything will be done by mother, done by the mother or family members. But think that, imagine such imagination I want to bring in your mind, that If you are living in the hostel, then who will take care of those all things? See, if your uniforms will become dirty, in the family, in the house, mother will wash them. No doubt. Okay. If you are living in the hostel, then who will wash? Correct? Huh? And about every your things. You should yourself only bath yourself. You should have to brush. Otherwise, what will happening in the house? Every time early in the morning, from the early in the morning, mother is asking to you to do everything. Brush your hair, go to washroom. Quickly, you should have to take your bath. And about your tuition classes, about your school, wear uniform, everything she will ask you again and again. But who will ask you in the hostel? So that's why mother is telling you how to be careful to look after yourself, since no one is going to ask you. How you are or care about your comforts? So you should have to take care about your comforts. You should also keep your all things correctly, neatly. Here things means I am talking about your notebooks, textbooks, pen, and everything. Bag. You have to speak up for what you need, because the hostel warden cannot give you the attention you receive at home. At the same time, you need to watch out for others, help themselves. See, in the hostels, in the home, our family members, our parents, they are taking care of us, and they are also taking care of our needs, no doubt. But in the hostel, such wardens are there. But here one problem is there, about which the mother is also telling to her daughter through a letter, that the hostel warden cannot give you the attention you receive at home. As much attention the daughter was taking in the home, that much attention she will not receive from the warden. Why? Because warden should look after all the students who are living in that hostel. For such a warden, the students are divided, just like 50 students for a warden, 100 students for a warden, so like that. So she should or he should have take care of all those 50 or 100 students who are living in that particular hostel. So because of that only, here mother is telling that warden cannot give you the attention you receive at home. So at the same time, you need to watch out for others. Not only you should have to watch about yourself, but also you should watch the need of others. And not only you should have to watch, after that you should also help them to help themselves. Okay. Next one. Don't think you are the only one with needs. Everyone will feel as you do, because it is a new situation for them all. If you feel homesick, you may find helping someone else through their homesickness will help you feel better yourself. See, don't think you are the only one with needs. So here the mother is telling that whenever you are living in the hostel, don't think that. Don't set your mind that, hey, I am the only who is needy. No. what the mother is telling, everyone will feel as you do, as you are feeling in the hostel. So everyone, whether in that hostel, in that particular hostel, 50 children are there, 100 children are there, or more than 100, 200 children are there. So like you feel, no, same feeling they had also. Why? Because it is a new situation for them also. As like it is a new situation to you, my daughter, as like the same new situation for those all students, those all children. So if you feel homesick means you can also see in the picture that every time the children are remembering their family members, and they felt very sorrow that every time they think that I am missing my family, I am missing my home, I want to go home, I want to see my mother, I want to see my father. So like that. So this situation is called, okay, if it will be for a few days, it is okay. But if it is continuing for months, for years, so this is called a homesickness. Okay. And you should also should not become homesick, and also you should help those all your friends who became already homesick. Okay. So you should have to try to them to come out from that homesickness. Okay. I want you to make the best of this experience, and I know you can. I also know that a new situation brings confusion because you are learning new ways to act. Don't be afraid to try new activities or introduce yourself to new people. And what here the mother wants? Mother wants that you to make the best of this experience. You see, children, this experience is the best experience. Because in the hostel, along with such strict rules, we should have to live. So here, mother also wants that her daughter also, she should get a best experience of these all things. And she also know that she can do it. And also know a new situation brings confusion in her mind. New situation means a new hostel, new friends, new warden, and such a new things, new rules, some strict rules. Strict rules means in the home, at what time you people wake up. Some will wake up at 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. But in the hostel, these chances you will not get. For everyone, there will be such a time is fixed to wake up, 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock. So such things are fixed. For example, tiffin time from morning 7:30 to 8:30 over. After that, if you are going, so you will not get your tiffin. So likewise, lunch time also fixed. Snacks time also fixed. Okay. Play time also fixed. Study time also fixed. And dinner time also fixed. So in between that fixed time only, if you are going there, then you can having those all things. Otherwise, you will not get. So that's why these situations, the mother is telling that these situations bring confusion because you are learning new ways to act. As for the rules, the daughter should have to act. And the mother is telling that don't be afraid to try new activities. Don't be afraid. Okay. beginning it will give so many problems to her, but what the mother is telling, try new activities or introduce yourself to new people, try to adjust with that new situation, the mother is telling. Look after your own happiness without waiting for someone to look out for you. But don't forget to look out for others' welfare too. And also, don't sit by imagining that someone will come and they will look after my happiness. No, these things will not happen in the hostel. So you should have to do your own happiness without waiting for someone look out for you. And as well as you should not forget to look out for others' welfare too. See, in the picture also, in the slide also, you can observe such an outing is there where in the flowing water the students are there, and one such a celebration they are celebrating, okay, and in the middle picture which is up to the water picture, they are celebrating one such a birthday, okay, and in the right side such a boy students are there where they are also celebrating their one such a small type of get together in their hostel room, and two more pictures also you can see. The left picture which is down, you can also observe the balloons, letters, so like that only. You should not give importance to your happiness. You should find out your happiness, your own, as well as you should not forget to look out for others' welfare too. You always have done this before, but now that you are on your own, I want to remind you that you are capable for such a responsibility. Don't let new surrounding confuse you too much. And you always have done this before. So in the home, what the mother is telling, in the home always you done these all things. But now that you are on your own, with the family members you did all these things, you have done all these things, but in the hostel now you are living alone. So what the mother wants from her daughter, I want to remind you that you are capable of such a responsibility. You are fit, you are you can do all the things with a responsibility, and don't let new surrounding confuse you too much. You should not become confused. Clearly you should have to think about all the things and fulfill your responsibility, the mother is telling. Okay, take your time to adjust, but don't forget to be aware of others' feelings even as you discover your own. At last, what the mother is telling, that take your time to adjust. Yes, it is no doubt that after being apart from the family, to everyone it will take a time to adjust in the new surrounding. So that's why the mother is also telling that take your own time to adjust, but don't forget to be aware of others' feelings. Others' feelings are also very important. See, in such a hostel, two students are living in a room, okay, in a single room. Many rooms will be there, and in such a room, many times are two students, three students, four students are allotted in a rooms. So at that time you should have to adjust first there, and don't forget to be aware of others' feelings. Other feelings also you should have to understand. And even as you discover your own, you should not forget yourself. First you should have to adjust, and along with your adjustments, you should also help to your roommates, to your classmates, that they should not feel homesick. Okay, they should not feel loneliness in the, yes, homesickness is nothing but a loneliness. Okay, they should not feel like that. Altogether, you should have make your own comforts, and with the responsibility, you should have to complete your education period. So not only here in this lesson, but everyone parent of us, they all are wishing the same. What they will wish? If my child is apart from the family, if my child is living in such a hostel, so every parent's heart, every parent's mind, it will think like that only. He or she should complete her full educational year very proudly. Okay, now what hostel life teach you? See children, the hostel life teach you what is mom. The hostel life teach you what is home. It will teach you what is pain. It will teach you what is food. It will teach you what is hungry. Hungry means in this lesson only I have discussed about such a timetable will be there for your tiffin, for your lunch, for your dinner, for your snacks. In between that time only if you are going there, then you are having your lunch, tiffin, snacks and dinner. If you will not, you will not get. So at that time, hunger. So it will teach what is hunger, what is friendship, what is money, what is lonely, and what is people, and lastly what is life. It will teach. So in one or another way, we should have the hostel life once in our life. See children, son or daughter, it doesn't matter to a mother. Her affection and love will be same. Always she showers her love like drops of rain. She is like a nature which is giving all the things of us to us without any expectations. She is also not expecting anything from us. Only the thing is, we should also understand her love and affection and should try to not hurt a mother's heart. With this, children, stay home, stay safe, wear masks, maintain social distance. Bye.